Welcome to Microsoft Ignite 2024 Unpacked. I'm Bob Laliberte, Principal Analyst with theCUBE Research. And one of the things we're unpacking is the technology ecosystem and how organizations are looking to span on-premises locations and Azure clouds. And to help me do this, we have Gretchen O'Hara, Vice President, Worldwide Channels and Alliances of Splunk, joining me. So welcome, Gretchen.
Thank you so much. I'm so happy to be here.
Yeah, it's going to be a great session. We're really looking forward to it. Let's just jump in and get started. You know, I talked a little bit about this, about the on-premises and cloud. I'm wondering, and clearly there's so many organizations that have been adopting cloud. We continue to see in all the research that there's going to be continued growth in the cloud. So how do you see organizations balancing that shift as they go from on-premises to cloud-based solutions? And if any, what challenges do they face during the transition as well?
It's a great question. I think that, as you had mentioned and have been, you know, talking to your viewers, all organizations are really focused on what does my new cloud infrastructure look like. I don't think it's a question of if, it's a question more of when and how, to your point. And but at the same time, in that recognition, there's also a balance between workloads that need to potentially stay on-prem or in private cloud or in a hybrid environment. And so one of the challenges I think that they face is what is going to go ultimately to reduce sort of costs and infrastructure and maximize sort of my ability to scale, and what do I need to stay on-prem? And so the reality here is that all of our customers are really looking at how do I build digital resilience and improve my security posture, and having a holistic view across IT ops, security, yeah, et cetera. And so I think you're seeing the value essentially of moving to the cloud, but being smart about where and how they place those bets, having their data in a place that is clean and optimized, making sure that they're capitalizing on the investments they've made in cloud infrastructure, and then have the skills through our partner ecosystem oftentimes to really support in the cloud migrations.
Yeah, absolutely. And what's critical that I've seen in these highly distributed environments, when you start moving things between the cloud and on-premises and so forth, and maybe that on-premises is not only data center but edge, is having that visibility between and amongst and across all of those disparate locations. So definitely, and hence why we wanted to have you on, trying to figure out, yeah, and maybe you can also explain a little bit more about how the SaaS offerings that you have, right? The cloud platform, the enterprise security, the IT service intelligence, you know, all these things that are now running natively on Azure, how that helps organizations to transform to the cloud.
Yeah, no. I think the first thing, and we're so excited about the announcement, there's been so much customer demand and so much partner opportunity around this. So first and foremost, we're very excited to be able to announce that general availability on natively on Azure. But it allows customers to integrate enterprise data and really power that digital resilience, being able to conquer hybrid cloud complexity that you just mentioned. Yeah. And then with Splunk's AI agility, then it just puts the opportunity for really smart decision making in the hands of those leaders to make really smart choices. And so what we're seeing across the globe is, how do you power the SOC of the future? These offerings essentially help making sure that there's unmatched observability that you had just sort of mentioned, like being able to see that in these complexity of hybrid worlds, unifying security operations and creating that enterprise-wide footprint to know what's actually happening across that complexity of the business. And then ultimately, detecting threats earlier, detecting threats faster, making sure that you're building out that digital resiliency for all of your data requirements. And so these SaaS offerings together on your investment of Azure Cloud is going to be able to do that in a very sophisticated way. And AI then, through Microsoft and Splunk, really then helps provide faster decision-making, reducing more costs, and again, still human in the loop, but putting those humans in the loop to faster decision-making across the business.
Yeah, I love that you brought that up about keeping humans in the loop. I'm a big fan of that, and I've always been inspired by that, the DIKW, the data, information, knowledge, and wisdom pyramid. Yeah. And so having the tools like AI to be able to sift through the data and create greater levels of information and be able to ultimately provide knowledge to end users, to the humans, who can leverage their wisdom as well to take action, I think is something that is going to be important in the evolution of AI, especially because so many of those resources we have today are so highly skilled at right. troubleshooting and digging in and doing things manually, but really into the details. And I think what I'm always concerned about is that 20 years down the road, you won't have that same level of skill. So the ability to have those resources today be an active part of the AI development is going to be so important.
It's such a good point, Bob. And I think that when you think about different types of workloads and use cases that require AI, and of course it's explosive and we're having AI conversation with every customer, but there are some things where you're going to see just AI automatically run and Gen AI be sort of applicable for those use cases. But when you're thinking about enterprise and digital resilience, right? And you're looking at the complexity that you just talked about across these enterprises, you wanna be able to take the work out of some of these administrative areas, but you can't take the people and the skill out of the decision-making because it may not all the time be something that you want to be able to automatically act on. You want to be able to really understand what is the security threat and where and how you are observing that, and then making those decisions with better and faster data. But I think when you're looking at things like enterprise security and observability, a unified platform that can serve those up for you, but have that human capability and intervention is absolutely critical around digital resilience.
Yeah, absolutely. So switching gears a little bit, you obviously are responsible for partners and alliances and so forth. What inspired this partnership between Splunk and Microsoft? And how has the partnership, the collaboration evolved over time?
Well, I think the inspiration was that our mutual customers all want to be able to provide the best digital resilience in their environments where they've been making bets on Microsoft Azure. And I think we both came to a realization that we have a strategic partnership that we should be building together to help our mutual customers. And that started us talking on what can we do together. We started with some BYOL on the Azure Marketplace as a way to get started. But the reality is to really capitalize on things like simpler administration around managing IT backends and reducing infrastructure costs and TCO, like improving that security posture and footprint, we needed to be natively on Azure to provide the best capabilities that we could and that customers could really recognize and realize that when they're making that bet on Azure. So that's how it really started. And then AI became an incredibly important component of that. It's a big bet, obviously, for Microsoft. It's a very important component for our customers. And so Microsoft has then connected and collaborated with us on what does that AI-powered digital resilience look like. And so that relationship is born, and we have the opportunity to empower partners to build new Splunk practices, as well as co-sell together with Microsoft to make sure that our mutual customers are seeing the best outcomes from their investments.
So I'm really glad that you brought up the partners and some of the opportunities, because I wanted to go there next as well and try and better understand what new opportunities this collaboration creates for those Microsoft and Splunk partners, and you know how it better supports their digital transformation journeys and maybe even their digital resilience as well.
Yeah, there is an incredible opportunity for Microsoft partners, and we're seeing a ton of interest. First and foremost, Splunk is an incredible solution that will drive Azure consumption. And so for partners that are looking at How do I activate these Azure consumption commitments with our customers? Splunk is certainly a set of solutions that can help that grow. So building ultimate profitability for our partners. But also there's practice areas that are really exciting. Obviously, enterprise security and observability, unified data platform, data optimization. I mean, data is accumulating everywhere when we look at data lakes and being able to do federated search. When you bring all of this opportunity together, partners now have a profitable business practice that one helps the customer ultimately with their digital resilience journey, but two creates deep practice opportunities that help essentially extend services. So for every dollar of Splunk, there's $6 of services revenue available for our partners. So I think collectively, you're going to see a lot of Microsoft partners getting on board to expand what they know in cloud migrations to build these practice opportunities. And our Splunk partners are going to be a great partner to partner in many ways where we need that great cloud migration skill or deep understanding of Azure infrastructure and bringing security and observability and data platform together. And I think you're going to see an explosion of opportunity across the partner ecosystem.
Yeah, that's great. And obviously there's always, you know, with the skill shortages that are out there, whether it pertains to AI, whether it pertains to the cloud, you know, they're so prevalent today that having those skilled resources that can come in and accelerate that journey is going to be so important for these organizations.
Oh, no question. And I think you hit on something that is just really critical because, look, you know, we know the financial climate that we're in. Everyone is being challenged to do more with less. And where and how can you optimize your IT and security spend? So partners can come in and fulfill so many of those deep expertise. And then, of course, we can, as Splunk, being on Azure, reduce those administrative costs and be able to really help provide essential support on the security and observability side. So really exciting.
Very good. So if I'm thinking of, you know, I'm a Splunk customer today, what practical advice can you give them? And what would you tell them are the benefits of them being able to, you know, migrate to Azure from their on-premises or even a self-managed cloud deployment?
Yeah, I think the practical advice is first, you need to understand what your cloud strategy looks like. So if you're a Splunk customer today, many of them have already committed or are looking at what that ultimately embedding on Microsoft Azure. So once you understand what that cloud strategy looks like, the next sort of practical advice is how do you make sure that you have your data in a place that you can have that optimized to take advantage of all of the Microsoft Azure capabilities. But then more importantly, you can get set up for very easy cloud migration ultimately with Splunk. So I think first and foremost, those two become really, really critical as they're evaluating. And then last but not least, just practicality is, again, you know, how do you reduce costs when you can go bring Splunk onto the cloud? You're getting kind of that two for one because you've made those Azure commitments, but Splunk will actually help you reduce your cloud commitment spend. So you're kind of getting a two for one as you look at total cost of ownership and ultimately creating a great expansion into cyber and how you think about your holistic digital resilient strategy.
Excellent. No, that's great. So we are getting short on time, but just real quick, I always like to ask, any chance you can share what maybe your future plans are with Splunk and Microsoft? Anything that customers can look forward to in terms of integration, innovation along those lines?
Yeah, well, I think one of the things that we're very excited about is we built a very strategic partnership with Microsoft. We're mutually invested in our customer success and mutually invested in each other's, solution set. So what you're going to see, I think, in the future is continued deep collaboration around AI. You're going to see Microsoft getting their capabilities and educating sort of the future and making sure that Splunk is current on capitalizing on those opportunities across Azure and across Microsoft and that Microsoft footprint. And I think you're going to see more about interesting opportunities where we're going to be able to go together to the customer and really help them with that cloud migration and ultimately improve their digital resilience. So I just say more to come. I think it's an exciting time. And I think the customers have been waiting for this, now have the opportunity to really take advantage of it because we have built this natively on Azure with Microsoft and our Splunk together to bring the best into the marketplace and just an incredible product suite.
Awesome. That's great. Well, definitely looking forward to seeing the uptake of the announcements that you just had and the future developments as they come. Unfortunately, that's all the time we have right now. But Gretchen, thank you again for joining us today.
Thank you so much. It was just a pleasure to be able to talk to you and the audience today. Thank you.
Absolutely. You're very welcome. And thank all of you for watching the Microsoft Ignite 2024 Unpacked. Stay tuned for more on theCUBE and look forward to a wrap-up at the end of the day. Thank you very much. Have a great day.